IHU is in France.
IHU too.
That was good. 46 different variations of this variant.
I've at this point I've lost track because I swore that we were going by the Greek alphabet. So I don't know when we got all the way.
That's
to
the
Z
whole reason and, why and I brought
back
this
around
up.
To I.
That's the whole reason why I brought this up because your thing was the next variant's going to be called Pi. So that's why I wanted.
They've
to
They've been
that.
Going, but listen, I don't have to. I don't have to point it out. I believe we all at this point know. If you just follow the variants that we've heard of, they all follow the Greek alphabet. So when did we skip all of these letters and get all the way back to I and to the point where now it's like a license plate? You know what I mean? Before you could have we had three letters and three numbers. Now you got to have a whole bunch more numbers. When did we get from Greek lettering to now there's not enough letters? So now we got to use acronyms.
I don't know, but what
it's like,
I
it's like area code 289. When did we get here? When did we get what I to 437? When
what
did
I we what get I here? Do know, what I do know is the numbers have been going down in our lockdown here in Ontario, and I think we're just under 12,000 today. And also what I wanted to point out. And the reason why I brought up this variant is because I follow CP24 on my Twitter. I don't have cable anymore. Cause why? And they used to post all the time breaking. And then, you know, the amount of cases now they don't do that. They breaking and the amount of hospitalizations. And then that's right. So right. I'm not gonna, you know, just quick run through from today. I think we're like at 2,400 hospitalizations. Mm-hmm. And but it's just the way that they articulate it, because they make it sound like it's 2,400 new ones, when in reality, it's just an increase from the previous days, which was around like 23, which is still a lot for
right. in the hospital. Right.
So they also spoke to some other interesting numbers. They talked about of those numbers, how many people are fully vaccinated. I think it's about 1,300. Of course, they keep it as vague as possible. And I say, of course, I'm not trying to be a shit disturber, but, you know, of course, like meaning they don't talk about age. They don't talk about when they were back, nothing like that. I mean, it's 1,300 people, right? How specific could you get? They also said something that I found kind of interesting. There's about 48 kids under the age of four. That are in the hospital, not in the ICU, that are in the hospital from COVID. Again, no specifics, you know, other complications that could...
Did they specify that they were under the age of four, right?
They did say that.
They specified that. Yeah.
So,
reason for that.
Okay, go ahead. What's the reason?
What's the age group of children that they opened the vaccination to?
Five and up.
Right.
And just to springboard off of that, so when I seen this, I started going through my timeline some more, trying to look at other news sources talking like, you know, not just CP24, but like global, whatever, right? City TV. And I just wanted to see what they were saying about the numbers. And I started thinking to myself, I'm like, so the number of people who are fully vaccinated, who are now in the hospital after getting COVID, there's still, and I'm not saying that you shouldn't, and I'm certainly not. My stance is still the same. It's up to you. But they are still pushing you should be fully vaccinated, get your booster, da 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 da. But then I say to myself, why aren't you putting this information in the breaking part? You know, the headline grabber? Like, right. Why aren't you putting it in there? You know what I mean? It's like you got to read the fine print to find out that people who are fully vaccinated, in fact, almost half, are also ending up in the hospital.
Right.
And my qualms with that, again, get vaccinated if you want. I am, it's up to you. But my qualms with that is, again, just keep it real, man. Like, tell people what the dealio is. Because a lot of people, including myself, I don't know a doctor, personally. I don't know a medical scientist. So I get my information from you guys, the news sources, the outlets, going online, researching. So if you ain't giving me the real, how can I make an informed decision? I don't like that the media does that. I got to be honest with you. I am saddened to hear that so many people who are vaccinated are in the hospital. It doesn't mean that I'm upset about my decision to get vaccinated. I still might even get a third dose, right? But I am saddened to hear that. And just because I am saddened, it doesn't mean I'm not going to tell our public that. Go to CP24 today, man, where it says breaking, and then click on the link and read it yourself. It's crazy. Why are they doing
it? I want you to take in the fact right now that there are people sitting at home who lost their jobs, right? And the people who were able to keep their jobs because they got vaccinated are now infected with Omicron, are hospitalized. There are people like that. I want you to understand that at this point, Justin Trudeau was on TV. I'm not sure exactly when, but he's still on TV talking about the unvaccinated people are the problem and are the reason why there's not enough hospital beds right now. This is a recent interview that he went on TV and said, and he's still blaming unvaccinated people for the spread and saying that they need to get vaccinated and all this type of stuff. I need you to understand that Quebec, the health minister, just recently announced that they're going to be changing the definition of fully vaccinated for their vaccine passports to where you're now going to be required to take 3 doses of a vaccine to be considered fully vaccinated. And this is Quebec Health Minister just announcing this. And they don't know when this is coming into effect, but it's probably coming into effect. And as with everything, because everybody likes to fucking talk about it, and it bothers me. And I told you before in the last video where we talked about it, that it bothers me. When something happens in Quebec, people automatically assume that it's going to happen here in Ontario, just immediately. And they will start talking about it. And when they start talking about it, it happens, because then it gives the government the excuse of, listen, people are concerned about this because they're talking about it. So I'm hoping it doesn't come to Ontario. I'm not vaxxed. I've never hidden it either. But I'm still hoping for those who already got their 2 doses and got it because they thought, or what was told to them, is by doing this that everything would go back to normal. I hope they're not required to go and have to get a booster shot in order to travel or do any of these things, because I know for a fact there's still going to be people, which baffles my fucking mind, who will go out and get another vaccine shot, watching all of these fully vaccinated people get sick, and some of them die still. So
for clarity, again, which I mentioned in my little preamble, we don't know, because they're not going to tell you. You know, over 1,300 people is a lot of people to break down in one article. But we don't know if they had, you know, they were immunocompromised or any underlying. We don't know any of that stuff, right? All we know is what is in our direct, like, I guess,
come on, man. There's logical. Right? That's all we know. You can think logically, right? Like, logically,
of course.
There has to be a person in the world out there who caught COVID, then, in order to keep their job, went and got fully vaccinated, and now has contracted Omicron.
For sure.
It's logical to believe there's one person that exists.
Oh, I believe that. For sure. I'm sure. I'm positive.
So, if you don't see how ridiculous that is, then I can't explain it to you. I can't. If you can't see how baffling that is, that they would push for a third dose after proof that the first 2 didn't work. They're not effective against whatever it is you were trying to do.
Well, here's the other thing, just to top up on that. Here's the other thing. Again, Omicron, different animal. But I read, even with the third dose, with a third dose, it's still only 54% effective against Omicron. And the effectiveness of that only lasts against Omicron for 3 months.
You see, and okay. So first of all, I want to be very clear when I say, because I don't want YouTube to come flag this. I want to make sure there's full explanation of what I'm saying.
Do your own research, please. Right. Go ahead.
No, yeah. I want to make sure there's full explanation of what I'm saying, because I said the first 2 doses were clearly not effective. How do I come to that conclusion? Because if they were effective, we would not be back in lockdown. I think that's a logical conclusion to come to.
Well, can I just interject for a moment, and then you could clarify, please? Because when you say they,
all right, but I'm trying to give the algorithm the full explanation.
That's fine. But when you said that they were clearly not effective, you know, of course, there was the OG COVID, then there was the Delta COVID, right? And you're saying, how are we here now? well, Omicron, which has been proven to be more transmissible,
right?
Holidays, flu season. So these are creating a basically a breeding ground for something that's more contagious to be transmitted.
Okay.
And also, I just want to say this last piece and then I'll let you go.
Okay,
I'll let you go. I promise.
Go ahead.
So when you say it hasn't been effective, it has against the OG and Delta. Omicron, different. All right, go ahead.
How was this vaccine thrown out to people? Was it thrown out as something that was only effective against Delta and Beta and whatever other variants? Or was it something that was put out that if you get this vaccine, this is what's going to solve the problem and we're going to be able to go back to normal life? Please answer that.
What I will say, so I'll answer that question. Yes, it was. And then I'll also jump off of that as well. Okay. You hearing that information and running with it is like when people heard Dr. Anthony Fauci saying, oh, this is at the very beginning. Oh, it's not going to be a big deal. You don't really have to wear a mask. And remember, this is when we knew nothing. And they heard that. It's at the beginning. You knew nothing. And they just ran with it. And they forever, it's like you can't learn new shit.
Right.
This is brand new. So when you hold on to that, to me, that's ignorant. Because the whole point of science is you're going to keep learning new stuff and you adapt accordingly. So you can't be like, oh, well, they said this once. This is new. They were wrong. So now you take what you learned and you apply it.
Right. You sound ridiculous right now.
But I don't.
Because for them, you do. You absolutely do. You absolutely do. Because pretty much what you're saying is we can't trust any of the information that they give us because we don't know what's coming down the pipeline. So them telling us to take the first two doses and then now this new variant comes out and it was unexpected.
Right.
So now we need to adapt, right? Now we need to adapt. This is what you're saying. So now their adaptation plan is to say you need to get a third dose.
Correct.
Why do we believe that information? If we already know, based on your theory, that something in the future is going to happen to completely change that, where now we might need a fourth or fifth or sixth dose. Why do we believe that they know what to do in this circumstance to deal with it? Because we're not just talking about this variant. We're talking about all future, because people don't want to be having to take vaccines for the rest of their life every time a new variant comes out.
I got to tell you something, homie. People get vaccinated on a yearly basis anyways. And just to answer,
but we're talking about every time a new variant comes out, there might be a new dose. We're not talking about every year. Mm-hmm. We're not talking about every year because the difference between Delta and Omicron is months.
Correct.
So months ago, we only needed two. Now we're a few months ahead and they're telling us we need three.
Maybe.
Maybe four. Why do I trust them now knowing that this might happen again? And now we got to get 5, 6 now. And then later, now we got to get 7, 8. And then we got to get 9, 10.
Okay, so here's the thing. Here's the thing, you guys. And when I say you guys, I'm also talking to you. Well, you. I don't know why when I point this way.
Anyway. I always point the wrong way too. So it's all good. Don't worry.
So here's the thing. All right. Here's the thing. And I've said this 100 times and I'll say it again. If you want to get vaccinated, get vaccinated. If you don't. There's consequences with being vaccinated. Still might end up in the hospital. Still might die.
The exact same as not getting the shot.
And there's consequences of not being vaccinated. And
all of us are in the same boat right now.
The point is, to answer your...
I had to take two jabs to get here.
To answer your question...
Ridiculous.
To answer your question, the people that I'm going to trust, I didn't say wholeheartedly, but the people that I'm going to source my information from and base my decision on are people who have studied in this field for their entire life. Mm-hmm. Those are the people who I'm going to source my information from. And when I say this, I'm lumping you into this group, but I'm not going to source my information from people who have not done any of those things.
I want you to understand that the sources that you have right now, mm-hmm. I want you to understand are the sources that are being pushed to you.
Right.
You are not going out. Like you said, you mm-hmm. don't know any doctors.
Correct.
You don't know any nurses.
Correct.
So the information that you're getting mm-hmm. is information that is being pushed to you through these different media sources.
Right.
These are people who are being put in place by governments and media heads to give you their information.
So now, so basically,
just pay attention to that.
So good. So if I'm to go on that narrative, essentially what you're saying,
I'm not saying that they're pushing false information.
Hold on for a second. I didn't say that.
This is not conspiracy theory.
I didn't say
all
that.
I'm saying is if you want an opinion of a doctor, you go to one doctor. He tells you got something. Sometimes you might go to a second doctor, get a second opinion. Nobody's really looking for the second opinions in this situation. They're just taking what is being given to them by the first doctor because they have the titles of health minister and chief medical officer.
So these titles,
what I'm saying, give them,
of course, the authority to get on these national platforms and speak to the population. So what I'm saying is, if I'm to listen to what you're saying, or according to you, what you're not saying, because you're saying, hey, man. Remember, you're getting all your information from somebody who is going on this platform and they are choosing who is you sound like a conspiracy nut. That's what you sound like.
That's fine.
Am I not telling you the truth though?
Is that not true? Are these people not selected?
Of course they are. Okay.
And are the news articles that selected. are the news articles that are pushed to people not selected? What is going to be pushed to people and what is not going to be pushed to people?
Hold on, the numbers
may be real. The numbers are probably real, but what is chosen to be pushed to you is a decision.
Okay, so I know you're an intelligent guy. Right. I know this. So, of course, you understand how a business works. You understand how a media company works. Right. So when you're a national station right across the country, you don't just let anyone go on. When you're a national station or newspaper, you don't just print anything. It has to be sourced. It has to be verified. It has to be authenticated. Of course they select. You're intelligent. I know this. You understand this. So when you say these things, what it sounds like you're saying is, well, CP24, Global, Justin Trudeau, they're all in on this conspiracy to vaccinate the entire world, because if that wasn't the case, they would be having people like you and Chris Sykes or whoever that guy is on the station. That's the point we're at right now,
after everything and after everything that they've done to people and all of what they require and the mandates and the passports and all this stuff. If you didn't pay attention, Justin Trudeau just went on TV and still blamed the unvaccinated people for the spread of this virus and the fact that there are no hospital beds. That is something that is being pushed to us. And if you can't see how that is fake narrative, that's a fake narrative that's being pushed. And that's our prime minister pushing that thing. I don't see how you can't see it as logical that somebody below him who's appointed could also be given things to say that are a little bit off, or maybe pushing a little bit more of a different viewpoint
First of all, I have one thing to knock that out in a second. But okay, what Justin Trudeau said, if he said that, I haven't heard it, but if he said that, that's ridiculous. And
I hate when you say that if he said that. Like, I just made this shit up. I haven't heard it. What you need to do is understand that I'm not sitting here telling you bullshit and just trust it. Don't discount what I'm saying.
What I'm saying to you is I haven't heard it.
I understand. So in order for me to respond to it,
I have to clarify I haven't heard it. But if he did say that, that's stupid. And if you have a functioning brain and you read, you would know why it's stupid. Now, the other thing, what you were saying, Justin Trudeau, the PM, the top shotta in Canada, going out and spewing nonsense. Why wouldn't people below him be doing the same, you say, right? You said that. Well, let's look at America. Let's look at Donald Trump, the president of America, talking about how stupid and fake COVID is, while Dr. Anthony Fauci beneath him was saying the complete opposite. So yeah, right. It happens.
Your point doesn't discount my point though, but it happens. It is hilarious.
Anyways, viewing public.
I like that.
Viewing public, IHU.
As soon as you said his name, it was hilarious. Donald Trump.
IHU, is this the new one? I don't even know anymore. I don't even know anymore. All I can say, and I'll leave you with this, whatever you have to do to make yourself comfortable in all aspects, I think, as far as just living your life as close to normal as possible and being safe. I don't care if you think I'm stupid for being vaccinated. I don't care. That doesn't mean I want you to be
sick. Drop a comment.
That doesn't mean I want you to be sick. I want you to be healthy. I want the people you live with to be healthy. I want when, however long this takes, when we get back to air quote normal, I want us to be able to sit down without a mask and have a drink and you to call me stupid to my face like this. Stupid. And it means like, nothing.
Like how I've been doing it the whole time.
And it means nothing. I want you to be healthy. At the same,
even before Omicron, I was telling you how dumb you are. But I understood why you did it. There's reasons.
At the same time, if you are like me and you choose to get vaccinated because you
get sick more often,
because you believe in the science, well, then I support your decision as well. You know what I mean? So that's what I think. And I stand on that and I stand firm on that. You went to UFT, right? You did, right?
Last time I checked. There's transcripts.
Listen, man, the stuff that you say, they're going to really want you to stop mentioning their school.
Because
they're going to be like, hold on for a second. 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 Because they're going to be like, wait a second. This guy did not go here. And if he did, we're going to have to scratch his face out just like they did that other nigga. Because the stuff you say is incredible.
Don't ever do that again.
Don't ever compare me to that
motherfucker ever again. Don't do that.
What are your thoughts?
Don't do that. You're not going to cut it off. You know, what no, you're your not going to. We're not going to go. We're not going to go.
Leave into, it in the comments.
After you leave a comment.
IHU UFT. What are your thoughts?
if you don't see it at this point, I know you're gonna get your booster. You're gonna get your booster shots. And if they tell you to get a fifth, sixth shot, you're gonna get that too. I know you. Yeah. To the point, like I said, to the point where, and this is hilarious because I said this on a previous video, there's going to be more vaccine in people's bodies than blood. And that's fine. If you wanna be an autonomous system full of vaccines pushing through your body, then go ahead and do that, man. Go ahead and be that.
Got it. I think Jay-Z said, what you eat don't make me shit. I think Jay-Z
that's said a horrible that. Bar, and he should take that out of all of his rap music that he's ever put in.
I think
it's a horrible bar and a horrible point. So I guess they go together.
It's a great point. Again, UFT. Talk to this guy, man. Leave it in the comments, you guys.
That's all you got.
I don't have to have anything more. You have your opinion. I have my own. You just have a sandwich wrap on your head.
I'm the one who's lost here. Yeah, for sure.
Look, Matt, I don't care. Look, I told you, I want you to be healthy forever. Make your choices.
Stop getting vaccinated.
I don't care.
I want you to be healthy.
Don't make me shit. I don't care.
Stop quoting horrible bars.
What you eat, don't make me poop.
This is not a horrible bar segment.
All right. Peace.